From Lee Jordan Field in Chugiak, Alaska, it is game number 17 as the Chugiak Eagle River Chinooks take on the Mat-Su Miners in the third game of the four-game set. Last night, the Chinooks came up short big time as the Mat-Su Miners drove in runs left and right, defeating the Chinooks by a score of a double-digit victory. And now tonight is the night for the Chinooks to try to get their revenge, and the pitcher on the mound to do it will be Braxton Wilkes. Garrett, what do you think of the addition to Braxton Wilkes in the rotation for tonight?
Well, for right now, it's just going to be, you know, a spot start and to kind of lengthen out the rotation, especially since the Miners have seen basically everyone the Chinooks have been able to throw out there. But Braxton, you know, one of those guys who's been solid out of the bullpen all year long, obviously next man up when it comes to that, but yeah, I mean, it's going to be a big spot for him. The Miners did not react well against the left-hander Connor Menez on Sunday, and hopefully, in the terms of Braxton Wilkes, that throwing from the left side will throw off the Miners, especially their left-handed power.
Absolutely, Garrett, and like you said, the lefty-lefty matchups could favor the Chinooks here, just as they did in Connor Menez's dominant performance back on Sunday. But without further ado, let's get to the lineups. First for the Chinooks, batting first and playing left field, Jacob Brobst. In center field, Dave Morin, he will be batting second. Playing at second base today for the first time in a long time, and batting third will be Matt Ferrudo. Batting fourth, the first baseman, Michael Staudinger. The designated hitter, Holt Davis, will be batting fifth. Catching and batting sixth, Tyler Boxwell. Batting seventh and playing left field will be Caleb Potter. Hunter Hanks playing shortstop, batting eighth. And in the nine hole will be the third baseman, Patrick Cromwell. And, of course, on the mound for the Chinooks, Braxton Wilkes. For the Mat-Su Miners, batting first and playing center field, Brick Paskowitz. Batting second, playing right field, Chris Hall. The left fielder, Vance Vizcaino, batting third. The designated hitter, Matt DiOrio, will be batting fourth. Niles Nygaard, batting fifth. Connor Wanhan in sixth. Tyler Wolf at seven. Zach Plunkett at eight. And Jake Schleppenbach at nine. And sorry to rush that lineup, folks, but it's just about time to play some baseball here as Brick Paskowitz steps into the box as the first batter that will face Braxton Wilkes this afternoon. The first pitch from Braxton Wilkes in there for a called strike one. Paskowitz on the year, batting 381. Five RBIs. The pitch. And the breaking ball in there for a called strike, too. A good start here for Braxton Wilkes. Really finding the zone on the first two pitches. The pitch from Wilkes. Just missed upstairs, trying to get Paskowitz to chase there. Paskowitz out of Paradise Valley Community College. A two-way player in the outfield, also serves as the closer for the Mat-Su Miners. The pitch, a swing and a miss from Brick Paskowitz, and the first batter that Braxton Wilkes sees today goes down swinging. Now stepping in for the Mat-Su Miners, Chris Hall, the right fielder. The first pitch to Chris Hall is grounded out, foul, out of play, down the first base line. So the count 0-1 here on Chris Hall.
To start this ball game, lefty, lefty, lefty. The Miners do in their order.
And Hall bangs that one foul down the left field line. So the count quickly 0-2 on Chris Hall. Hall comes into the game batting 276 on the season. The 0-2 pitch from Braxton Wilkes. Breaking ball in the dirt. Taken there by Chris Hall. So the count moves 1-2. So one ball, two strikes, one out here. Top of the first inning. The pitch from Wilkes. And that's banged foul. So 1-2 coming all over again.
Actually, five guys in the batting order tonight are left-handed for the Miners.
The 1-2 pitch. And that is into center field. And a diving Dave Morton cannot make the catch. The throw to second base will be not in time. David Morton trying to basically extend his entire body there in center field. Could not make the grab. Not that you could really expect him to make the grab there. So,
yeah, max effort by Dave Morton out in the center field and coming on, especially playing the other way. But as the left-handed hitter, Hall, it was hooking right back towards him. So he had a good chance at that play. It hung up there.
So Chris Hall into second base. That'll be marked as a single. With the advance on Morton dropping the ball there. So the pitch from Braxton Wilkes to Vance Vizcaino. Just misses low, ball one. Vizcaino yesterday. A four-hit day for the three-time Major League Baseball draft pick. And Vance Vizcaino lines that one to the third baseman, Patrick Cromwell, who overthrows Michael Staudinger. Coming around third into home will be Chris Hall. The third of the plate is not in time. So a throwing error there from Patrick Cromwell to Michael Staudinger. Allows the advance from Chris Hall, and just like that, Garrett, the Miners have a 1-0 lead in this ballgame. And if you're a Chinooks fan or Chinooks manager Jordan Vieira, you're thinking, not this again. Errors plaguing the Chinooks last night.
It's usually the first inning.
Absolutely. So now Matt Diorio to the plate. The first pitch, pop foul back into the screen. So the count 0-1, a runner on second base. Diorio comes into the game batting 364. And Braxton Wilkes missing there, the count 1-1. One ball, one strike, one out in the game led by the Mamatsu Miners. By a score of 1-0 here in the top of inning number one. And that pitch, a breaking ball from Braxton Wilkes, sails in for a called strike. So the count 1-2 on Matt Diorio, the designated hitter out of the University of Central Florida. The 1-2 pitch from Wilkes. Just misses on the outside, so the count 2-2. The 2-2 pitch. And never mind, Braxton quickly turning to Vance Vizcaino at second base. The 2-2 pitch, and that's low, ball three, so the count goes full on Matt Diorio. As Braxton Wilkes, yet another pitcher for the Chinooks that has to already battle through the mistakes that have been made out in the field. The pitch, and that's going to be ball four. So Matt Diorio trots over to first base, the first walk of the day issued by Braxton Wilkes. And Gary, it's a shame that what really could be runner on second, two outs, is now runners at first and second, one out.
Yeah.
Talk about a different situation here for Braxton Wilkes.
Completely changed the situation, but however, Wilkes looks like he's going to get some help here.
And the batter was Niles Nygaard, and he popped the first pitch to first baseman Michael Staudinger, who was under it to make the grab for the second out of the inning.
And that as well, he's also, you know, being a lefty, you have that unfair advantage as a left-handed pitcher to be able to pick at first base.
So now the highly touted prospect Connor Wanahan steps in. The Big 12 Freshman of the Year. Comes into this game batting just a buck 25.
Yep, total of 2 for 16.
Yeah.
Did help pad his stats a little bit last night. A very good night. A 1 for 3 night, a stolen base, couple RBIs. Starting to come around.
The 1-1 Hanen. Outside, ball one.
Except you remember his first game against the Chinooks back on June 25th. This guy, Braxton Wilkes, comes into the ballgame in relief with the bases loaded. Juan Hanen goes away 4-6-3.
And Wilkes has pitched there, in there for a strike. So now the count 1-2 on Juan Hanen, runners at first and second. Two outs here in the top of the first. The Miners leading by a score of 1-0. Wilkes looks back to second, sets, delivers, and Juan Hanen cracks that one into left field, but under it is Caleb Potter to make the third out of the inning. So errors plague the Chinooks yet again in the top of the first, but Braxton Wilkes manages to come out with just one run on the board. And compared to yesterday's effort, Garrett, that is definitely an improvement. Yesterday, the Miners put up a 4 spot in the top of the first.
Yeah, I mean, just the one run, and you got to be very fortunate with that. And on the flip side, you know, he's able to get out of trouble and, you know, really make guys get themselves out. And that's the beauty of Braxton Wilkes, and that's how efficient he can be. And, you know, when you have a lefty like that out of the bullpen, and now you can put him in a starting role when need be, we'll see how he can go. And you know he's got length because he worked 5 2/3 in relief against the Miners on June 25th. We told you about Juan Hanen grounding into that double play, but he only gave up a run on 6 hits in a 4-0 loss to the Miners at Herman Brothers Field. So, I mean, or actually that was back here, but, you know, Braxton is a guy that has a way of, you know, could he have that secret kryptonite for the Miners' bats? We'll see here as this game progresses.
And, you know, Garrett, the thing about the Miners Chinook series thus far this season, now though it has in the wins and loss column been very lopsided towards the Mat-Su Miners, with the exception of last night's debacle, it has been a very kind of even, entertaining series, and the Mat-Su Miners being, you know, the team with the best record in the Alaskan Baseball League, and many pro prospects, like scouts, would argue that they probably have the most stacked lineup in the Alaska Baseball League. The Chinooks are playing them very well. But if you're going to beat a team like this, it comes down to pitching, situational hitting, and not making errors in the field. And yesterday, the Chinooks could not do really any of that. And, you know, they really got it handed to them. But now the Chinooks are going to come out to bat here in the bottom of the first inning. The first batter that's going to see the pitcher Brigham Hill out of Texas A&M is going to be Jacob Brobst.
Yeah, a pitching staff that only allows 1.1 runs every 9 innings. Brigham Hill with a 3.0 ERA. Believe it or not, that's kind of a break against a pitching staff like that.
So the first pitch to Jacob Brobst, in there for a called strike. Brobst comes in batting 317. That's second on the Chinooks roster in batting average. And Brobst takes again strike two. So Jacob quickly falling behind in the count here, 0-2. Many may remember that on Sunday when these two teams matched up, Brobst with an RBI in a 2-for-4 day. So Brobst takes that one for a ball. So the count 1-2.
He did wear an 0-for-4 collar yesterday, but looking to bounce back.
He did. And Brobst swing and a miss. Strike three, and that's how the ball game starts here for the Chinooks batting order. So now Dave Morin steps up to the plate, the center fielder. Not by regular position, but with Cam Baranek being injured for the past week or so, Morton's kind of stepped in the center field role and done pretty well. The first pitch to Morton, taken on the outside, ball one.
And needing to get Caden Owens out of the lineup to get some rest as well. So Morton has been that third option, but he's been a good one.
Yeah, Morton, the everyday second baseman at Xavier, but he's basically kind of a utility guy. He can play wherever you really need him. And Morton cracks that one foul down the left field line. And I was talking to Dave the other day, and I said, you know, do you like playing the outfield? Do you dislike it? He's like, I'll do anything. If it's helping my team, if I can get in the game and help the team, I will play any role. I will pitch. I just don't recommend they put me in as pitcher. The count 1-2. And Morton grounds that one to the second baseman. Jake Schleppenbach's the third to first. Just in time. So Morton goes down on the 4-3 for the second out of the inning. And now the batter, Matt Ferrutto, here with two down. Bottom of the first inning, the Matsu Miners lead by a score of 1-0.
Now batting for your Chinooks, number 9, Matt Ferrutto.
Ferrutto batting 349. That's 15 for 43. He has a pair of doubles, 8 RBIs. Also a pair of triples. The first pitch to Ferrutto in there for a called strike. Ferrutto out of the University of Alabama, Birmingham, the 0-1. And Ferrutto pops that one up sky high. Chasing it back is Zach Plunkett in foul ground. And he's under it to make the grab for the third out of the inning. So the Chinooks go down 1-2-3 in the bottom of the first. And after an inning of play, the Matsu Miners lead by a score of 1-0. We're going to step off for just a second here. But we'll be right back here with you from Lee Jordan Field with all the action. Don't go anywhere. You are listening to Chinooks Radio. And welcome back here. We are in the top of the second inning. The Matsu Miners leading by a score of 1-0 here. And leading things off here in the top of the second for the Matsu Miners will be Tyler Wolf. Wolf out of Kansas State comes into the game batting just 152.
About the only guy that Schultz could keep out of the hit column last night. He was 0 for 4 with a walk.
The first pitch to Tyler Wolf fouled back into the screen. So the count 0-1. And Chinook's pitcher Braxton Wilkes has been a traveling man, starting at Kansas State his freshman year, spending the last year at McLennan Community College, and headed to Abilene Christian in the spring. And the future Abilene Christian pitcher throws it in there for a called strike two, a fastball on the inside corner. So the count 0-2 on Tyler Wolf. And two guys that have had the opportunity to call themselves Kansas State Wildcats just at different times. The 1-2 count to Tyler Wolf. Swing and a miss, and Braxton Wilkes gets the Kansas State Wildcat Tyler Wolf swinging there for the first out of the inning. Braxton's second strikeout on the day. And now here comes another Big 12 guy. Playing in the state of Texas, TCU's Zach Plunkett, the catcher. The first pitch to Plunkett misses on the inside, ball one. Plunkett comes in just 1-for-6 on the year. That's a 167 batting average. He's only played in two games. And Braxton gets a little bit wild there. Misses way outside, gets past Tyler Boxwell, so the count 2-0 on the catcher, Zach Plunkett out of TCU. And Plunkett has been regarded highly for his ability behind the plate as he fouls that one back. He is a top-notch defensive catcher. And for a lot of what the Matsu Miners have been using him for, it has been defensively. But of course, the other catcher, J.J. Hancock, in a larger sample size, not hitting very well himself. And Wilkes throws it in there for a called strike, a fastball sailing right down the middle.
Yeah, the only catcher that really off to a good start in the month of June is Matt DiOrio, but he's been used as a designated hitter.
Yeah, almost exclusively. So the count 2-2. Wilkes pitching out of the windup here. Wilkes sets, delivers. In there for a called strike three. He got him looking. So two straight strikeouts to start the top of the second inning. And that's one way that you don't have to rely on your fielders to not make errors.
Yep.
Strike them all out.
Even better, he did it against the two right-handers that he would see in this inning. The only other one in the order is Niles Nygaard. He got him out as well.
So now the batter is Jake Schleppenbach, the second baseman. A Nebraska Cornhusker comes into the game batting 152. And Schleppenbach lines that one right into the glove of Michael Staudinger at first base for the third out of the inning. So Braxton Wilkes sends them down 1-2-3 in the top of the second. And like Garrett said, how key is it with the lefty-lefty matchup here being a very prominent thing that Braxton Wilkes gets them? All three of the righties in the lineup for the Matsu Miners retired their first time up.
That's huge. I mean, especially, you know, since he's only given up the one base hit that came around to cost him a little later thanks to an error, and that wouldn't be up there if it wasn't for it. But, you know, just a rushed throw in that first inning, and that's the only reason it's 1-0. But Braxton Wilkes is pitching very well against this Miners lineup, holding him quiet so far.
And Braxton Wilkes has been one of the most consistent pitchers in the Chinook staff so far. Coming out of the bullpen, he basically carried them to victory in one of the games against the Gold Panthers. Just, I can't emphasize enough, he was a Chinook radio player of the game that day. In the game that I believe maybe Connor Menez started, Wilkes came in when... Oh no, check that. It was the Grant Page start. And Wilkes came in, pitched like five innings of worker, four something along those lines, holding them scoreless. I believe actually holding them hitless. And gave the Chinooks the opportunity to rally in the late innings and continue their winning streak up there in Fairbanks. So Wilkes, a picture of consistency so far this season, has shown nothing short of that so far today. But for the Chinooks to be successful, it's going to come down to... They're going to have to hit the ball already down 1-0 in this game. We've already seen them lose 1-0 to the Matsu Miners last week. Not wanting a repeat performance cannot be shut down at the plate. And now in the bottom of the second inning, trying to start things off for the Chinooks will be Michael Staudinger. The first pitch to Staudinger is inside at the feet, ball one. Stauds comes into the game batting 236. The pitch, and Stauds pops that one up, foul ground. Niles Nygaard chasing it into foul territory, under it to make the grab for the first out of the inning. And now we're going to see the designated hitter, Holt Davis. Holt Davis comes into the game batting 267. Kind of been switching in and out between the designated hitter role and the first base job. The first pitch to Davis, a curveball in there for a called strike. And Davis waves at that pitch from Brigham Hill. So he's falls behind quickly in this count, 0-2. And Davis calling time there.
Not a bad idea just to get the pitcher out of his rhythm in an 0-2 count. Smart decision by the UAB Blazer.
So Hill sets, delivers. Outside, ball one, the count 1-2. Davis, a former member of the Rochester Ridgemen, that's a New York team in the AIA system. The 1-2 pitch, swing and a miss, and Holt Davis goes down swinging for his first at-bat and for the second out of the second inning here.
Coming to the plate for the
Chinooks,
number 15, Tyler Boxwell.
And now Tyler Boxwell to the plate. Boxwell was about 1 foot away from having a home run last night, but bounced off the top of the wall and back into play, so he was limited to a double there.
Maybe even less than a foot. He only needed a fraction of an inch the other way to hit that
wall.
Yeah,
he really hit the top of the wall and basically... It was just the momentum and the angle in which it hit that kept it in the yard. But yeah, Garrett's right. It was really more of a fraction of an inch.
A little bit further. A little more topspin. A little more backspin even.
So Boxwell ahead in the count 0-2 and fouls one right back into what directly would have hit my face. Back here, if you saw maybe our camera shook a little bit there.
That's solid.
Oh, wow. Garrett Mansfield, the engineer of camera angles here. A man of many tools. 2-1 count to Boxwell. And Boxwell checks his swing there. Goes ahead in the count 3-1.
Really one of the more disciplined at-bats we've seen so far through six hitters for the Chinooks. Boxwell going 3-1.
The 3-1 pitch, and Boxwell grounds that down the first base line. That's a fair ball getting past Juan Han, and Boxwell going to stay at first. So the first base hit of the day is to Tyler Boxwell, a single that tiptoed like a gymnast on a, what's that word called, the trapeze, or...
Oh, on the...
Balance beam.
Yeah.
Balance beam. It was like a gymnast on a balance beam down the foul line. Anything could have tipped it to the side, but it stays fair all the way. Getting past Connor Wanhanen.
Had Wanhanen playing off the line a bit. It got right on by.
So now Caleb Potter, the batter. Caleb Potter takes a big swing and a miss.
Wanted to put the Chinooks on top with that swing. Almost had it if he got the contact.
And that's a theme with Caleb Potter. We saw him put a couple out in batting practice the other day, and swing and a miss there again. And Potter, we're just waiting for that first home run, because he has shown in batting practice and in, you know, practice and stuff, and with deep foul balls, that he could definitely put one out of the yard. It's just a matter of waiting for that pitch. But Potter quickly falling behind 0-2 here. Bottom of the second, the Miners lead 1-0, two outs, Tyler Boxwell at first. And a big swing and a miss there for Caleb Potter. Goes down swinging, so after two, the score still 1-0 in favor of the Mat-Su Miners, both teams with one hit apiece. We'll be right back here for the third. Don't go anywhere to our 11 viewers. We'll be right back. You are listening to Chinooks Radio.
And we head into the top of the third inning here from Lee Jordan Field. The Mattsu Miners lead by a score of 1-0. Both teams with one hit apiece. And now the Miners about to go through their order for the second time around, and they're going to start things off with Brick Paskowitz. The first pitch to Paskowitz, low ball one. Paskowitz started off this game going down swinging. The 1-0. In there for a called strike. And Paskowitz pops that one up. A fly ball into right field. Under to, there to grab it is Jacob Brobst for the first out of the top of the third inning. So Paskowitz starts the game off 0 for 2. And now Chris Hall to the plate. Chris Hall, 1 for 1. He ended up coming around to score.
An unearned run against Braxton Wilkes.
The pitch from Wilkes. Hall tries to bump that one, but it goes foul right under Tyler Boxwell's leg, so the count evens up 1-1.
It is a run, but it will not blemish his ERA any. Braxton still under 1 through his 11, or make that 16 innings of work.
And that kind of tells the story of the kind of pitcher that Braxton Wilkes has been for the Chinook so far this season.
He is a two-way player, really and truly. Good defense.
He was one of the few guys that could hit the ball yesterday.
Yeah, he had a couple of hits, and I'm sure with the outfield in question, he'll be still getting more at-bats out there.
And Hall grounds that one to the first baseman, Michael Staudinger. Gets past him. Ferruto there to back him up. But an infield single for Chris Hall. His second of the day, and the second of the day for the Mattsu Miners. And now, for the second time today, Braxton Wilkes will face Vance Vizcaino. Vizcaino, his last time up, reached on an error by Patrick Cromwell rushing a throw, which ended up resulting in a scored run. The first pitch to Vizcaino, taken low, ball one. And Vizcaino, a very, very talented guy. The 1-0. In there for a called strike.
Got on board 5 times last night, scored 4 runs, 4 hits.
And for those of you who come to Alaska and kind of waiting to see who guys who might end up in the pros, you point to Vizcaino as a guy who definitely has a shot. Mm-hmm. He's going to get his minor league shot. He's gotten the offer 3 times already. And he has the frame.
Really does, 6'3", 210.
And the pickoff attempt there, advancing to second, but the throw gets under Hunter Hanks. Just a bad throw by Michael Staudinger, so Chris Hall advances to second on that one. And that's inexcusable, Garrett. Not good. The throw there just literally in the dirt. About. And it wasn't a throw in the dirt from the catcher. It was a throw in the dirt from first base. So the count, 1-1, 1 out here. Runner at second base. The pitch misses on the inside, ball 2, so the count 2-1 on Vance Vizcaino, a guy who we are pretty set to see as a member of the Alaska Baseball League All-Stars. The pitch, and that got really the handle of the bat there, a foul ball coming right back into the screen, evens the count at 2-2. Almost looked like it may have hit him on the hands.
It was close. He was trying to get out of the way, and just ran up and got the lumber, came straight back.
So top 3, 1-0 Miners, 2 balls, 2 strikes, 1 out, runner at second.
And Braxton Wilkes looks back to Chris Hall at second base. And Wilkes trying to keep his team in this as they look to find their offensive groove at some point. The 2-2 pitch, and Vizcaino pops that one foul out of play down the left field line. Two balls, two strikes, one out. 1-0 Matsu Miners in the top of the third with a runner at second. The pitch, and that skips in the dirt. Ball three, scooped up there by Tyler Boxwell, and the count goes full.
Wilkes really having a battle here against Vizca, you know, also got to be careful. He could plate another one.
Oh, absolutely. He has shown time and time again against the Chinooks his potential. The pitch, and Vizcaino grounds that one to Hunter Hanks. Hunter Hanks, the throw to third, not in time. Patrick Cromwell not in there with the tag quick enough as Chris Hall slides right under the legs of Cromwell and the tag of Cromwell in there to third. So count that as an infield single or fielder's choice base. So yeah. Vizcaino on with the fielder's choice. And now, runners at first and third, one out. And some trouble here for the Chinooks in the top of the third. The first pitch is blooped into left field, and that's a fair ball. Coming to score is Chris Hall, rounding third. Will be Vance Vizcaino, but as he comes to third trying to slide in, he is tagged by Hunter Hanks, who was covering the bag there. And Vizcaino kind of just smiles as he trots away, questioning the call there. But the Miners get another one on that one, an RBI single for Matt DiOrio. So now a runner at first base, two outs here. The Matsu Miners lead 2-0. Over the Chinooks here in the top of the third. The first pitch to Nygaard in there for a called strike. And Garrett, that was almost kind of like a little cheap hit there for the Matsu Miners, but that's baseball. You take what you can get. And Nygaard rocks that one into center field. Tracking back as David Morton makes the grab for the third out of the inning. But the Miners get one more in the top of the third. And now lead the Chinooks by a score of 2-0. We're going to head into the bottom of the third now. And the third inning looks to see Hunter Hanks, Patrick Cromwell, and Jacob Brobst. Now some interesting changes to the lineup today. David Morton batting second. And I guess Jordan Vieira kind of looking to see what he can do in the top of the lineup, giving a break to Will Bass. Kind of a much-needed break for Will Bass, who playing every day kind of got himself into a little bit of a slump, and maybe a day off will be good for him. And, of course, the bottom of the order staying the same. With Hanks and Cromwell there, both are guys who are kind of struggling a little bit at the plate, but stay in the lineup for their defensive prowess. But the Chinooks' main infielders, Patrick Cromwell, Will Bass, and Hunter Hanks, batting 128, 140, and 156 respectively. So with the offensive struggles, you gotta hope that when the infielders can get back into their groove, and of course the return of Cam Baranek, if he can perform like he was performing before, the Chinooks can get back into the way that they were playing during their 8-game win streak. So now Hunter Hanks steps up to the plate. Hanks 156, 5 RBIs on the year. And Hanks pops that one and it rolls just foul as it lands in fair ground right in front of the catcher, Zach Plunkett.
That was excellent awareness by Plunkett, because he could have easily picked that one up and not had a prayer to get Hunter Hanks at first base. He was already about 60 feet down the line by the time it rolled foul.
So the count, 0-1 on Hunter Hanks. In a 2-0 game in favor of the Massey Miners, the pitch taken on the outside by Hanks. The count 1-1. And Hanks, good contact, but goes foul down the right field line.
Did a good job, stayed back on a pitch away, sprayed it the other way, but just a little bit too late. Maybe a millisecond late.
So a 1-2 count on Hunter Hanks here in the bottom of the third. The pitch upstairs gets that past the glove of Zach Plunkett. The count evens at 2-2. And Brigham Hill, one hit allowed on the day so far. And the 2-2 pitch from Hill has popped up to the second baseman, Schleppenbach. He is under it to make the grab for the first out of the bottom of the third. And that's going to bring up Patrick Cromwell. Cromwell on the year, 128 batting average. That puts him at 5-39.
Has not recorded a hit in his last 7 games. Hitless in 16 at-bats against the Miners.
And Cromwell cracks that one to the third baseman, Nygaard. The throw in time for the second out of the inning. So Patrick Cromwell goes down quickly.
It continues.
Coming to the plate for the Number 23, Jacob Probst.
So to the top of the order we go, and Jacob Probst, his second at-bat of the day, his first time up, went down swinging to start this one off. The first pitch to Probst, taken low. Ball one. And Probst in 41 at-bats, 13 hits, 12 strikeouts. So the majority of the time, if you're Jacob Probst, he's either cracking a single or going down swinging. And Probst waves at that one. The count 1-1. The pitch, and Probst lines that one foul out of play. So one ball, two strikes, two outs here. Bottom of the third inning and a 2-0 lead for the Mattsu Miners. The Chinooks with just one hit on the day and have committed 2 errors. And that kind of tells the story. The pitch, swing and a miss for Jacob Probst, and that is going to end the Chinooks in the bottom of the third inning. So after 3, the Mattsu Miners for the 2-0 lead. We'll be right back here for the top of the fourth inning of action. Well, stay tuned. You are listening to Chinooks Radio.
Tab of inning number four, the Chinooks trailing the Matsu Miners in a score of 2-0. Braxton Wilkes back on the hill for the Fish for his fourth inning of work. His first hitter he'll face, Connor Lonhanen at a TCU. Wilkes, the left-hander, fires first pitch. Ruled a strike to Connor Lonhanen on the outside part of the plate. Wilkes, fastball, curveball, changeup. Getting the spot start today for the Chinooks. Lonhanen, two bouncer to the shortstop. Hunter Hanks fields and throws across the infield for out number one. So Connor Lonhanen, his struggles in the ABL continue. He is just 2 of 18 and 0-for against Braxton Wilkes. That brings up Tyler Wolf. This is the part of the order Wilkes made quick work of the first time through the order. Wolf struck out his first time to the plate to lead off the second inning. But Braxton Wilkes back up there for the Chinooks. First offering to Wolf misses a little bit low for ball one. Wilkes has just surrendered two runs, but just one of them is earned on three base hits. The 1-0 misses downstairs 2-0. The Tyler Wolf out of Kansas State. A couple of guys who have attended that university at different times, however. And Wolf turns and pops this one up a mile high in the shallow center field. Coming in is Dave Morton, and he makes the grab out in center field for the Chinooks. That'll be out number two. Bring up Zach Plunkett. Plunkett also struck out. Plunkett also at a TCU. Very, very good defensive catcher we've seen so far in these first couple of games we have been able to witness. The offense still waiting to come around. He waves at the first pitch from Braxton Wilkes. A strike. Plunkett is just one of seven with four strikeouts so far this season. Struck out all three times on Sunday against Connor Menez. That pitch misses downstairs. Makes it the ball and a strike. Of course, the Chinooks shutting out the Miners 2-0 here on Sunday, turning around tomorrow, or yesterday, that is, as the 1-1 misses from Braxton Wilkes in on the hands of Plunkett. Yesterday was not as pretty. A 13-2 win for the Matsu Miners. The Chinooks playing catch-up again tonight, down 2-0 with two errors of their own up on the scoreboard. Plunkett waves and misses at the 2-1 pitch from Braxton Wilkes. Trying to count even at 2-2, so Wilkes looking for his second 1-2-3 inning of the night. Wilkes peering in over the amber mitt on his right hand. Fires inside. Plunkett leans out of the way of that one. Makes it a full count. Zach Plunkett just hit 149, playing in 21 games for the Horned Frogs at TCU as they went on to the College World Series. On the third, Cromwell has it. Throws from deep third base for the third out of the inning. Strong inning for the Chinooks defensively as the Miners go down 1-2-3 here in the fourth inning, bringing us an opportunity to take a peek at the Alaska Baseball League scoreboard. Here in the middle of the fourth inning, 2-0 Chinooks trailing the Matsu Miners. Out of town, in Fairbanks, the Peninsula Oilers visiting the Alaska Gold Panthers as they play just one game tonight. Played a doubleheader yesterday, but the Panthers leading 2-0, bottom of inning number 3 in Fairbanks. The Oilers swept the doubleheader yesterday. They won 3-2 and 9-0 over the Gold Panthers, and the Oilers are actually now tied for the league lead in hitting. With the Matsu Miners, both teams hitting 265. And then in Anchorage, the Bucks and Pilots playing a non-league game tonight. As the Glacier Pilots and the Bucks scoreless in that one. Because we had just got gifts in the press box all of a sudden. Courtesy of Bill Stoltz, our fine representative of the state Congress. But anyways, moving on, as that scoreboard check from around the ABL is brought to you by the Alaska Club, where the Chinooks work out. Should go over there and work out, too. Excellent facility in Eagle River, Anchorage, Wasilla, Palmer, you name it. Basically, if it's a area of central population in Alaska, they do have an Alaska Club.
That is very true, and the Alaska Club's facilities are amazing. Garrett making himself familiar with the one in Wasilla or Palmer that you say is so impressive.
Wasilla, very impressive facility. Eagle River getting a pool next summer. Very excited about that. Number two hitter in the order for Jordan Vieira tonight. David Morton will lead off. The bottom of the fourth is Dave Morton. He fouls that pitch into the glove of Zach Plunkett to begin the inning against Brigham Hill. Brigham Hill and a Texas A&M, and Dave Morton splashes that one into center field. A leadoff single for the man out of Xavier.
And famous Dave finally making the big-time contact he was looking for there.
He was on that one. A laser to center field, and now a runner aboard for Matt Ferrudo, one of the few men in Chinook's uniforms that has really had an impressive ledger against the minors this year. He's 8 of 21 against the Matsu minors, a clip over .333. Before his first at-bat, he fouled out to the catcher, Plunkett. Takes the first pitch strike from Brigham Hill. Hill is 0-1 on the year, but he does have a lead. Here in the bottom of the fourth inning, his offense is giving him some help. Brigham Hill, the right-hander out of Texas A&M, comes set. The 0-1 pitch to Fruto, away ball one. He was the count up at 1-1. Brigham Hill is from Nacogdoches, Texas. That's where Stephen F. Austin is located. Former Chinook, Lance Phillips, also from Nacogdoches. 1-1 is the count on Matt Ferrudo. The pitch, he swings and misses. Throw back to first is not in time, as Morton got a little bit too much of a secondary lead for Zach Plunkett to be comfortable with, so just making sure he stays over there. Count goes to 1-2. Chinook's trailing 2-0 to the minors in the bottom of the fourth. Nobody out. Ferrudo, Stottinger, Davis to follow. Barring a double play, Ferrudo digs back in on the right-handed side. Hill fires home, and Ferrudo bangs that ball foul to the right side and out of play. But Hill, a freshman at Texas A&M this last year, only had 3 starts. Struck out 23 over 18 innings. Pretty impressive there. Checks Dave Morton. He's back to first base and steps off. So we'll still do it at 1-2 here. A lot of guys from A&M we've seen in this Alaska Baseball League. Here's the 1-2 pitch, and Ferrudo hits that ball high and deep down the right field line, but it'll hook well foul. So the 6th pitch of this at-bat will have to come. Brigham Hill up to 42 pitches now. 43 will come here. Of course, the key has been get to the minors' bullpen, but, you know, that's not very easy either. Here's the 1-2 pitch to Ferrudo downstairs. Make it 2-2. So Ferrudo having a very good at-bat, making Brigham Hill earn the whole thing. Texas A&M, Brigham Hill, same university as my Cleveland boy, Johnny Manziel. Hoping he can lead my Brownies to some victories this year. 2-2 is the pitch to Ferrudo upstairs and away, ball 3. So a full count on Matt Ferrudo. That's asking for a little bit much, isn't it, Andrew?
Yeah, Garrett.
We've been asking for that ever since they came back into the league in 99.
Yeah, I mean, the Browns.
We thought Tim Couch was savior. Tim Couch. 3-2, the count on Matt Ferrudo.
Garrett, you're hopeful, if not anything.
Well, yeah, the conversation. Actually, we'll get to that story here in a after this at-bat, Ferrudo fouls that one back. Actually, why not start it now? The Macklemore song about the Mariners going to the 95.
My, oh, my.
Yes. Thank you.
I can't believe it. It just continues. My, but, oh, my. Great song.
That that song, very good one, Baseball Jammin'. You know, the year that was, in 95. Of course, the Mariners went on to, it reminded me that the Mariners went on and played the Indians. Friddle, on the hit and run, gets it by the second baseman, Schleppenbach. Morton on his way to third. Another hit for Matt Ferrudo. Stay hot. Now first and third for the Chinooks.
The Chinooks are now in business, finally getting something going.
2-1, nobody out for Michael Stoniger.
And the Chinooks with first and third, nobody out. When we talk about the keys to the game, no errors, pitching, situational hitting. This is where situational hitting comes in big. It would be a crying shame for the Chinooks to come out empty-handed, and even with just one run, with all the potential that they have here.
They need to find a way to cut down this lead. So Matt Gurley is really the pitching coach for the Myers, going to come out and talk to all of his infield. That gives me a chance to finish out my story. So, the McLemore song, okay. Now, that talks about the 95 division series for the Mariners as they went on. Ended up playing the Indians in that 95 ALCS. And that's what reminded me. Heard it earlier today in the van. And so they played the Indians in that ALCS. Indians go on to win that. Knocked the Mariners out. A very good Mariners team, by the way, as well.
Ken Griffey Jr.
And not the only team the Indians knocked out of the playoffs that was probably better record-wise. Of course, the Orioles in 97, the Indians knocked out. And then
they lost to the Florida Marlins that year in the big show.
Jim Leland, the manager of that Marlins team. Edgar Renteria.
It's almost kind of funny, right?
But the moral of my story was, you know, how good were those Indian teams in the 90s that came up empty-handed, and that just seems to be the theme for Cleveland
Atlanta
sports.
Braves only won one World Series in their long string of success.
Yep, had a very close one with the Yankees. That's outside to Michael Stoniger for ball one.
If you think about it, Major League Baseball, the team that wins the World Series isn't always necessarily indicative of who is the best team that season. I mean, the San Francisco Giants are never the favorites
deepest.
Coming in. Yeah. But always the deepest, and that's what it comes down to.
Playoff baseball. 1-0 the count on Stoniger. The pitch swung on, yanked over the head of the first baseman, Juan Hanna, but it's going to go just foul. What a hit from Stoniger. Had everybody... here to the left of our score shack, out of their seats.
That would have been big time.
First and third, nobody out. Big spot for Michael Stoniger. Stoniger hasn't really been the same since he left Fairbanks, but he is prime for a big one here. That pitch is found to the left side and out of play yet again. Stoniger, that big body and lots of power. Definitely capable of just creating stuff with his bat. Playing first base for the Chinooks today. Does have 5 RBIs on the year. 1-2, the battle with Brigham Hill. He fires home, bangs that ball to the third base side, just wide of the bag.
It's like he's infusing hope into the hearts of the Chinooks fans and players with all these so close hits.
He has had nothing but good contact in this at-bat against Hill. Hill really...
laboring.
Really working for this one. Had to work against Ferrudo, who's down at first base. The 1-2 breaking ball grounded to first base. Juan Hanan goes to second for one. The relay will be not in time, and it gets away from everybody, but it won't advance Stoniger, but so he'll get credit with the RBI as he brings home. Dave Morton cuts the lead down to 2-1.
And now the Chinook's finally getting production out of the two-hole. Yesterday with Braxton Wilkes, today with Dave Morton. A spot that hadn't really produced much in a couple of days, going back to really the Chinook's Matthew Miners game. That
Holt Davis takes ball one. Just one out, a runner at first now. Michael Stoniger, his 6th RBI on the year. But a big run here in the 4th. That magical 4th inning has come back. Davis waves and misses at that 1-0 pitch from Brigham Hill.
It looks like he was trying to replicate his triple that he had against the Glacier Pilots there.
Holt Davis, another big guy in the middle of the Chinooks lineup. Right-handed hitter. Hits out of an open stance. 1-1 in the dirt, blocked by Plunkett, making it 2-1. But yeah, those Indians teams in the 90s came up empty. Of course, those Orioles teams were pretty darn good as well, with Ripken towards the end of his career. Yankees and the Braves really dominated that era. Swung on, fouled back by Holt Davis, not to mention steroids.
It's kind of funny how, like, low-key the Florida Marlins have won two championships in their
existence. Remember their last one?
03.
Last one, you know, think of the guys on that team. Josh Beckett.
Dontrelle Willis.
Dontrelle Willis, 190-pound Miguel Cabrera at 19.
Think about that.
Just tiny, and now he's ballooned up to a monster. 2-2 to Davis, misses inside. Arguably the best hitter in baseball. Of course, if Jackson Beck was at the ballpark tonight, he'd argue that one with his man, the machine, Albert Pujols. 3-2 count on Holt Davis. Brigham Hill steps off. Stottinger back to first base. Stottinger grounded into a fielder's choice, giving the Chinooks just a one-run deficit here in the fourth. Davis trying to add on to it. The payoff pitch, swing and a miss. Snap throw to first. Stottinger back there in time.
It's almost kind of interesting, Garrett. Hey, you can see the development of someone like Miguel Cabrera, you know, at 19 with the Florida Marlins, and throughout his career as he develops into a guy that, at this point in his career, you realize that people are going to be talking about this guy's career for a long, long time.
And, you know, you look at him when he won that championship back in 03. First offering here to Tyler Boxwell, misses outside for ball one. Boxwell with a single back in the second. Boxwell went 1-for-4 off the top of the wall last night with a double. Just missed a home run. 1-0, hits the outer edge for a strike. But a guy like Cabrera, you know, you look at a guy like, you know, even Barry Bonds as a young player with the Pirates, how small he was and how big he got. 1-0, or 1-1 misses outside, 2-1. And then you look at Miguel Cabrera, almost the same thing. It's amazing. One steroids, one not. But, you know, it was just the era.
It really was.
You know, it's a very heated, interesting topic. And then, you know, question of guys are going to be in the Hall of Fame or not just because of that. And you look at it, and some guys were really the best in their era. Those are the guys that get enshrined. And it's an era that everybody did. The pitchers did it. Hitters did it. Relievers did it. 2-1 to count on Boxwell, swing and a miss.
It's heavy stuff, Garrett.
It's certainly a big conversation, and a lot of the baseball writers are very adamant against it.
I think you got to put him in, honestly. That's just my opinion. Just
I would.
You asterisk the entire generation of players and call it for what it is.
2-2 to Boxwell. That's down in the dirt, blocked by Plunkett, makes it a full count. Then you got guys like Miguel Cabrera doing it the Babe Ruth way.
Much more honorable, per se.
Well, if you call a case after every game honorable.
Well,
3-2.
Babe Ruth, an interesting character in our country.
Payoff pitch off of Stottinger, Boxwell with a drive to deep right center field. On his horses, Hall reaches up. He's not getting this one. Stottinger around third. He's going to try to score. The throw to the plate is cut off, and this game is tied.
And Tyler Boxwell, his second double in as many days, coming up clutch. And, you know, hitting catchers, not a problem for the Chinooks this season. And Foxy Boxy putting his team in this game. The mustached man. And talk about a guy who's been hot recently.
Batting for the Chinooks, number 32, Caleb Potter. Here's Caleb Potter with a runner in scoring position. The Chinooks have tied this game at 2. First offering, Potter fouls it straight back. What a tear Tyler Boxwell is on. Second extra base hit and 2 games. Breaking ball to Potter, hits the inside part of the plate. The Chinook's just continuing to hit.
Big spot here for Caleb
outs.
Potter.
Yeah. Potter with a chance to give the fish the lead. Brigham Hill with a long look in. He comes set, and Potter wisely calls time. And despite only being a sophomore-to-be, that's a very veteran move by Potter, someone who's been around the game a long time. Calling time.
No question there,
Do your
there,
deal
Gary.
As a hitter. 0-2 pitch, high ball one. Makes it 1-2.
And good job by Potter laying off there.
You know, maybe the Chinooks, you know, sometimes here at Lord of French, you know, you have that weird angle with us. Sometimes if it's really quiet, the hitters can hear us. Sometimes the pitchers can hear us. Sometimes the outfielders can hear us. It just depends what happens. And the 1-2 swing and a miss by Potter. It's going to be held on. It's in the dirt, actually. And the throw to first, and he got him just in time. Monhanan, they think he might have pulled his foot, but regardless, strikeout is complete, and that retires the side, but the Chinooks grab a pair to tie the game at 2, and Andrew, the quick thought to end the inning, but maybe the MLB talk might have distracted them a little bit, made them a little bit more comfortable on the plate. But after 4, the Fish have tied this one. We have a 2-2 ball game. We head to the 5th. Yes, you're listening to Chinooks Radio.
And it looks like in the bottom of the fourth, they're actually going to give Caleb Potter the base on the drop third strike call. So now two outs here, and Hunter Hanks is at the plate.
So Hanks will be the hitter with two outs. Swings, hits that ball in the air. Not deep, hooking foul to in foul ground, and Rick Paskiewicz makes the catch, so I guess the ball never lies.
True that.
So it does not hurt the Miners. So now we'll step off in the 5th coming. top of inning number five we go. The Chinooks and the Miners in a newly tied ball game, and what a weird fourth inning that was. But regardless, the Chinooks, two runs on four base hits, two errors. Braxton Wilkes fires this one home to Jake Schleppenbach for strike number one. And the Miners have two hits, or two runs of their own, on three hits and the one error by Plunkett on the throw. Breaking ball from Wilkes goes about 60 feet, but didn't get the other 6 inches to get across the plate, so that's ball number one. Wilkes, the lefty, rocks and fires, and Schleppenbach bangs that ball foul behind the plate. As Andrew and I were talking off air, just a strange inning, and it really wasn't. I mean, as far as the beginning of it, it ended kind of weird. So we were off the turned out Caleb Potter reached on an error on the strikeout. 1-2 misses outside, 2-2, just to give that clear. So it's a strikeout swinging. The error on the catcher, Plunkett. He reached first base, the appeal, and at home, he said he did definitely pulled his foot. Schleppenbach yanks that one foul to the right side. Goes out of play. One of those, you know, we were kind of conspiring. That might have been a makeup call from earlier in the week.
Very well could be. You know, same umpiring staff that threw out Jordan Vieira back against the Glacier Pilots.
2-2, Schleppenbach. Shallow fly ball, shallow left field. The shortstop, Connor Hanks, is out there in the shallow left field. Makes the play on the fly ball off the mat of Schleppenbach.
And that's about as deep as a shortstop's going to make a play into the outfield.
Yep.
Connor Hanks calling off Caleb Potter. Trekking about 15 yards to get that one, where Potter only had to track about 5 feet.
Yeah, but a textbook play by the shortstop going behind third base in the shallow left. First offering to Haskowitz, a soft ground ball up the middle behind second base. Hanks has it, but Rick Paskowitz aboard on an infield single. It wasn't hit very hard. And right behind second base, and you saw Hunter Hanks having to track a lot of ground to go towards the left field line to get a ball in the air.
Hit.
And Hanks having to come up the middle on that one. So to give the Miners their fourth hit of the night, Rick Paskowitz aboard with an out. And Chris Hall, 2-for-2, a couple of runs scored. Both of them. It's all the Miners runs. Pickoff play at first. Paskowitz back safely. Chris Hall out of Tennessee. Playing for Dave Serrano there in Knoxville. Breaking ball high from Braxton Wilkes to begin the at-bat. Dave's son, Kyle, a pitcher for the Matsu Miners last year. He actually made the trip up here to check on some of his players. He only had quite a few playing with the Miners, some more with the Bucks. 1-0 inside, just almost hit Chris Hall.
That was close.
Makes it a 2-0 count. In a 2-2 ball game, we're in the top of the fifth inning. Braxton Wilkes pitching very well for the Chinooks in a spot start. Another pickoff play at first. Back there safely is Paskowitz. Areas of clouds all day long. And pretty chilly day here in Chugiak, but it's been tolerable. Another pickoff play at first. Paskowitz is back, and he's got speed over there. Probably one of the more all-effort guys on the Miners team.
Yeah, talking to, and I'll touch on this in a second, talking to Kevin and Kyle over in the Miners booth, he was saying that Rick Paskowitz, after playing a game in the field, when the Miners bring him in to close, he doesn't want to take warm-up pitches. He says, I'm hot. I'm ready to go.
2-0 pitch from Wilkes, misses high and away, ball three. First time he's been in this situation. Why not? Chris Hall's hit you hard. So 3-0 is the count on Chris Hall. Could be taken all the way here. Here's a 3-0. Downstairs, ball four. So puts runners at first and second for the Miners.
Advance this Guyano coming up.
Yeah, but Vance missed Guyano. Missed Guyano, 0-for-2 officially. Reach on a fielder's choice. Was a race on a fielder's choice. And reached on an error back in the first. that allowed Hall to score. So this guy, you know, coming in hitting 321. First offering from Wilkes, swung on, bouncer up the middle. There is Ferrudo, steps on the bag, to second for one. The relay in time, double play for Matt Ferrudo. Up the middle.
And talk about exactly what you needed, exactly when you needed it. Matt Ferrudo quickly steps on the bag there. Tosses it over to first for the double play.
So that'll take us to the bottom of the fifth, midway through this ball game, as the Chinooks and Miners deadlock at a 2-2 score, as Braxton Wilkes, Brigham Hill, forced with a couple tough tasks, playing very well today. So the Chinooks will come up with Cromwell, Brobst, and Morton due up this inning. Gives us a chance to remind you all about social media for the Chinooks, as we are online everywhere. If you're on Facebook, most of Alaska is. Chugiak Eagle River Chinooks, give that page a like. Oops. And if you are on Twitter, at CER Chinooks. And also, if you're listening to our broadcast tonight, you know how to tune in, so tell your friends. Head over to CERChinooks.com, hit the Nooks Nation page, and Andrew and I will be here all season long. Fish coming up on a big road trip over the weekend.
Me and Garrett are very consistent. We are always here.
Yeah, always. Each and every day. Putting in the work.
It's almost uncanny.
Patrick Cromwell will lead off the bottom of the fifth for the Chinooks, as Braxton Wilkes has worked a couple of scoreless innings back-to-back here, as the Miners and the Chinooks deadlocked at two. Brigham Hill winds it up the first offering to Patrick Cromwell. He bangs that one up the middle towards Tyler Wolf. He's got it to throw to first in time, but Patrick Cromwell, solid contact to lead off the fifth. Brings up Jacob Brobst, a couple of strikeouts so far for the Ohio State Buckeye. Brobst hitting 317 coming into play today. An 0-for-4 last night. 4-of-15 against the Mat-Su Miners. Out of Ohio State, of course. One of the greats out of OSU. Nick Swisher. Breaking ball, strike one to Brobst. The field named after Nick Swisher there at Ohio State. Helping provide funds to get the turf and all that. Brobst takes that one downstairs for a ball from Hill. Ty Beck races across, grabs the wild pitch. 1-1 count, one gone. Even on the scoreboard, despite two errors for the Chinooks, one for the Miners. 1-1 offering to Brobst. Breaking ball hits the inside corner for a strike. Of course, the at least one of them for the Chinooks cost them a run. 1-2 offering to Brobst. High ball two. Vance Vizcaino reached on an error by the third baseman Cromwell. Got away from Stottinger at first base, allowing Chris Hall to come all the way around and score. 2-2 pitch to Brobst. Swung on, fouled right back at the screen. And that could be the difference in the game. The other error for the Chinooks came in the third, as Stottinger tried to turn two. Here's the 2-2 offering to Brobst. Swung on, hit the other way, and foul yet again to the right side. Cal remains 2-2 with one out here. Bottom of inning number five. Chinooks tied up with the Miners. The one error for the Miners didn't really cost him. It was a throwing error by Zach Plunkett, the catcher. after a strikeout by Caleb Potter. First baseman Connor Wanhanen pulled his foot. 2-2, Probst hits that one towards third. Nygaard up with it cleanly, flips it across a diamond, and just in time to get Jacob Probst. So Probst 0-for-3 to begin his day. Now David Morton got the rally started last inning with a single to center, followed by a Matt Ferrudo single. I got him to third. And Michael Stoddinger with the fielder's choice to bring home Morton. And then Tyler Boxwell, the big crack, with a deep fly ball to right center to double home Stoddinger from first. First offering to Morton, misses upstairs for a ball. Brigham Hill. Two runs, both earned on four hits. Breaking ball, outer edge for a strike to David Morton. And six strikeouts for Brigham Hill. Braxton Wilkes, just three on the other end. No walks either from Hill. 1-1 from Morton. Bounce it right back to the mound. Hill has it. The underhand flip to first. And that'll retire the Chinooks in the bottom of inning number five. But we go to the sixth. Tie ball game here at Loretta French Park in Chugiak. You are listening to Chinooks Radio. We'll be back in a moment. Tie ball game back in Chugiak between the Matsu Miners and the Chugiak Eagle River Chinooks. Tie game in Anchorage, too. Bottom of the fifth there, Box and Glacier Pilots in a non-league game. Just an exhibition down there, 1-1.
So we literally don't care.
It's for the Anchorage City bragging rights. Isn't that why they do it? Isn't it like a little thing?
First offering, bouncer to second base. Ferrudo has it. The long throw in the middle of diamond in time. Matt Ferrudo, have a night at second base.
No kidding, and Ferrudo's defensive skills may be brought a little bit into question. But no issues there.
They get Matt DiOrio, a tough out in the minors' order.
Batting for the minors, number 16, Niles Nygaard.
Niles Nygaard to the plate now for the Matsu Miners, 0-for-2 to start the day. First offering from Wilkes, misses outside for ball one. Other game in the league tonight, Peninsula Oilers and the Alaska Gold Panthers. And Fairbanks. Pitch from Wilkes misses upstairs to go to 2-0. Oilers and the Panthers in a 4-1 ball game. Home team on the advantage in the Gold Panthers. 2-0 to Nygaard. Big cut and a miss. So that is your ABL scoreboard here into the sixth inning. Brought to you by HealthWise Care Center. Wilkes the 2-1 inside just off the corner. Whoa. Makes it a 3-1 count.
Look at the velocity he had on that one. Had some movement too.
So Wilkes winds it up the 3-1 to Nygaard. Outside ball four. Third walk of the night for Braxton Wilkes with one out. Brings up Connor Wanhanen. Freshman phenom from TCU. Wanhanen, a Flower Mound, Texas native. Standout in high school, won a state title his senior year in baseball, and went to the College World Series his freshman year. Ball one from Wilkes DeJuan Honan, Big 12 Freshman of the Year, College World Series, All-Tournament Team, 1-0, and Juan Honan rips that one to the right side and out of play.
And right now the guy throwing in the Chinooks bullpen is Jason Carchetti.
Haven't seen Carchetti work in a while. Wondered if we were going to throw him into the rotation here for a spot start, but Wilkes, the lefty going, misses upstairs 2-1, and it's paid off. So Wilkes going at least 5 1/3 strong, went 5 2/3 into relief the last time he pitched against the Miners. Wilkes, pickoff play at first, back in time is Nygaard. Miners have had now three more base runners. Up and in to Juan Honan, makes it a 3-1 count. At least three more base runners because of the walks. Four base hits apiece, two runs apiece. Pair of errors for the Chinooks, one error on the night for the Miners. 3-1 pitch to Juan Honan, that's in the zone. Making a full
big
count.
Pitch.
Big pitch from Braxton Wilkes. Wilkes did get Juan Honan to ground into a double play the first time these two squared off. And Juan Honan's first game in the ABL last weekend. So here's the 3-2 pitch. Swing and a miss! Wilkes blows it by Juan Honan. He went up the ladder. Connor Juan Honan sat back down 0-3 to begin his night. And now Tyler Wolf. Wolf 0-2. A strikeout and a fly out to center field. Wilkes, the lefty, fires home. Misses outside, ball one. One and oh is the count. On Wolf, pick off throw at first by Wilkes, not in time. Obviously, not really showing the great pickoff move.
And not to put the cart in the head of the horse in any way, shape, or form.
Out and up and away, ball two. So Wilkes starting to lose his control a little bit. Not much. He's still been able to get people out. Possibly the last inning of work for him. On a solid, solid start. 2-0 inside corner for a strike. Makes it 2-1. The Chinooks and the Miners playing for the seventh time on the year. The 2-1. Wolf lines this one softly in the center field. That's a base hit. Runners at first and second. Two outs for Zach Plunkett.
And this is a big, big spot here.
And here,
looks like Vieira's going to come and take the ball.
Looks like it. So he's going to come to the mound, talk things over with two outs for the right-handed hitting Zach Plunkett. And we'll get a right-hander on the hill. And Jason Carchetti will step off and allow the pitching change to occur. And we'll be right back on Chinooks Radio. Two outs for the Mats, Ian Weiner to the top of the sixth. I think Jason Carcetti on the pitch for the Chinooks. Carcetti in his fifth appearance officially in league play. Just have five games of work overall. First hitter he'll face is Zach Plunkett. He's 0-2. First offering from Carcetti, swung on in the air, shallow right field. Under it is the right fielder Brooks for the out, and easy work to begin the inning for Jason Carcetti. As we head to the bottom of the sixth, and Carcetti hasn't allowed a run over his last five and a third innings of work. And the one time he did, the one run he has allowed in the regular season against who? The Matsu Miners. In a 3-1 game back in on June 13th to open up the official home opener back in the beginning of June. But Carcetti coming in, making quick work of the Miners as we head into the bottom of inning number six. And that gives us an opportunity to remind you of the upcoming schedule for the Chinook. Miners and the Fish will be right back here at Loretta French Park again tomorrow night at a 7 p.m. first pitch. And game number 11 out of this 11-game stretch, the Chinooks finally a day off on Thursday, July 2nd. Then they'll break out with the game at the Pilots on Friday night. It'll be a 7 o'clock start and then at Kenai.
Have we really played 11 in a row tomorrow?
Really,
wow.
Saturday, Sunday, and Monday will be in Kenai. So those of you in Chugiak listening in tonight that weren't able to make it to the ballpark or locally will still be here for all three games in Kenai, and the Chinooks looking to stay perfect in non-league action.
I just can't believe it's been a month. I mean, not a month, yeah. But 10 days, whatever. The 10th day in a row. We haven't gotten a day off since we beat the Bucks here.
Yep, and really it's been, and it has been a month, Andrew, and the month of June, and a strong start for the Chinooks. They're 9-7 they are guaranteed an above 500 start in the month of June for just the second time in 4 years since the Chinooks have been here. The last time they did it was in 2012. They finished June with an 8-6 record. The first time they were here, when Jason Carcetti's older brother, Steve, was just a sophomore in college. Hard to believe that. And now he's a pro baseball player.
Wow.
Matt Ferrudo will lead off the bottom of inning number six in a 2-2 ball game between the Chinooks and the Matsu Miners. Miners have had the Fish's number so far. Pitch misses inside from Brigham Hill. Miners are 5-1 head-to-head against the Fish. Chinooks are just 3-7 against their own division. Hard to believe that. Of course, most of that is because of the Miners.
Unfortunately, yes.
1-0 to Ferrudo. Hits the inside part of the plate. Makes it 1-1. Chinooks also just 2-4 at home. Some of that basically because of the Miners.
Yeah. I mean, we've played the Miners a lot. That's the only way to put it.
1-1 offering to Matt Ferrudo downstairs and low.
And folks at home, just... You know, when the Chinooks struggle against the Miners are pretty much by far the most talented team in the Alaska Baseball League that will
pretty
play.
Pretty close, yeah.
Like.
Apart, I mean, you know, you're going to have a mix of talent no matter what throughout this league, and only six teams to choose from, so they really stack them up. So Matt Ferrudo, the 2-1 pitch to him, swing and a miss there, goes down 2-2. Ferrudo, a single back in the fourth inning. Got Dave Morton to third base. Part of back-to-back singles and a three-hit inning that tied the ball game. Ferrudo digging back in, leading the Chinooks in hitting. The 2-2 swung and hit the other way to right field. Going back is the right fielder, Hall, and he makes the head-high catch. For the out. One gone. For Michael Stottinger. Picked up the RBI back in inning number four. And he eventually came around to score on the Tyler Boxwell double. He Hill, the first offering to Stoudinger, bounces in there, goes to the backstop for ball one. So Michael Stoudinger, now 6 RBIs on the year. Definitely a guy that can make this a 3-2 game with one swing of the bat. He rolls this one to first base. Hanna takes a weird hop. It's off his mitt. And Stoudinger aboard on the air.
And that was just kind of a picture of Connor Vanhanen's inexperience in the field. Now, Vanhanen, as successful as he was this season in college, used mostly in the designated hitter role. One of the things he wanted to work on here in Alaska was kind of find a true position, and the minors have been working him between right field and first base. Now, this is, I think, his third start at first base, and, you know, just a clear sign of inexperience there, and the Chinooks benefit from it.
Swing and a miss by Holt Davis, the first offering of the at-bat. So that'll be the second error of the game for the Miners for now. So here's the 0-1. In the dirt, gets away from Plunkett, goes to the backstop. Stoudinger advances on the wild pitch.
And now the Chinooks, the go-ahead run in scoring position with one out. And Holt Davis at the plate right now, and the hottest guy in your squad, Tyler Boxwell, standing in the on-deck circle.
Big time with less than one out runners in scoring position. For what it's worth, they haven't left one there today outside of Boxwell in the fourth because he reached 2 outs. That's the key. If you can get him there with less than 2 outs, you got to get him home. So a 1-1 count on Holt Davis. Davis does have 4 ribbies. 1-1 pitch, misses upstairs, 2-1. Although, mishap by Connor Vanhanen. Took a weird hop on him. Did get leather on it. 2-1 to Davis, misses away, 3-1. Brigham Hill is ready, the 3-1 offering. The pitch swung on, hit to the right side, hooking in the foul ground. Paskowitz is there, drops it.
Oh, wow.
So, fresh life for Holt Davis.
And Stoudinger was ready to tag up and go to third there, but the umpire waves it off, saying he dropped the ball in foul ground. And Holt Davis with a pair of strikeouts on the day, trying not to have a similar fate here.
So here's the payoff pitch to Davis, upstairs, ball four.
And, you know, you can only ask so much from one person, but...
So a pitching visit here from Matt Greeley here.
And, you know, the... Still not much going on in the bullpen for the Mat-Su Miners, but Matt Greeley going to come out and have a chat with Brigham Hill. And Brigham Hill working almost statistically to his 3.0 ERA right now, kind of working towards the expectation. But Tyler Boxwell, Foxy Boxy, the master of disguise, looking to become a different person here and drive in some runs for the Chinooks. And he's having a quick chat with hitting coach Taylor White as White's going to trot on back to first base. And a big spot here for Foxy Boxy.
Yeah, arguably one of the bigger at-bats of the game. Boxwell came through to tie the game back in the fourth. And really one of the more dangerous hitters in the Chinooks order all of a sudden. So Brigham Hill in a tough spot. First and second, one out. First offering to Boxwell. Misses outside, ball one. Boxwell two for two, a single and a double with an RBI. Two of the four hits from the Chinooks. Davis down at first base with a walk. Hill is ready. Steps off. Take a breather. Tyler Boxwell is Stephen F. Austin. He'll be a senior next year. Here's the 1-0 to Boxwell down in the dirt. 2-0. And considering the struggles at the bottom part of the order, Boxwell, kind of in a magnified position right now to get that lead off or the go-ahead run aboard, or home, excuse me. 2-0 pitch to Boxwell. That's in the zone from Hill. He really reached back and fired one in there. Makes it 2-1. Bottom of inning number 6 in a 2-2 deadlock between the Chinooks and the Miners. The Miners got their runs in the first and third. The Chinooks with their 2 in the fourth. We've been all square ever since. Turn at second base. Back there safely is Stoniger. No throw from Hill. One man throwing in the bullpen for the Miners. Can't quite get a number on him right now.
And that's Caleb McCann.
2-1, up and in the box, Bill. Makes it 3-1. Yeah, looks like McCann. Could be.
At least got the facial hair.
I see a 2 on the back of the jersey. Can't see the other one. 3-1 on Boxwell.
Might be James Harrington.
The 3-1 from Hill in there. Full count.
Well, that was close. That was a very close call. Brigham Hill attacking the inside corner on Tyler Boxwell and getting the friendly call from the home plate umpire there. And now a full count in a huge spot for Tyler Boxwell.
Full count on Boxwell. Hill, the ready. The pitch swung on, hit the other way towards left. Back is Vizcaino. He's under it, makes the catch. Retreating are all runners for the Chinooks. Big out if you're the Miners. And Boxwell got good wood on it. Just didn't quite have the position. If that was a gapper, it would have been 4-2. So Caleb Potter is tasked with trying to get at least one run home, give the Chinooks a lead going into the seventh.
Big spot.
Potter. Big. First offering, it hit him. Up and in from Hill. Potter doesn't look pleased, but regardless, the bases are loaded.
Caleb Potter, I think, might leave the Chinooks to hit by pitch on this season. Showed me his battle scars the other day, and they're prominent.
Between walks and hit by pitch, he has gotten on base a lot. Really came up and in from Hill. Ben Taylor, Matt Greeley still at the foot of the Miners' dugout. Bullpen continues to work. For Hunter Hanks. Hanks does have 5 RBIs, so his few amount of base hits have been big. First offering from Hill. Hanks takes that one outside, ball one. Bases loaded situation. Bottom of the 6th inning. And a rare base is loaded against the Miners.
Seriously, though.
Hill coming set. The 1-0 to Hunter Hanks. Swung on, hit high in the air to left. Vizcaino ranges under it. He's got it. And that retires the side. And so the Chinooks will leave them loaded, but threat. And still a 2-2 tie for the Chinooks and the Miners as we go to the seventh. You're listening to Chinooks Radio. We'll be right back.
And to the top of the seventh we go. We are all tied up here at Lee Jordan Field in Chugiak. Andrew, Alex, Garrett, Mansfield here on the call. And leading things off for the Miners in the top of the seventh will be Jake Schleppenbach. The first pitch from Jason Karkeny misses on the outside of breaking ball. The count 1-0. Karkeny on the year. ERA in the threes, but like Garrett said, the only run surrendered against the Matsu Miners. He has been scoreless in all of the rest of his outings. So the count 2-0 here to Jake Schleppenbach, the pitch, and Schleppenbach's fly ball, center field. Under it is David Morton, makes the grab for the first out of the inning. So Dave Morton grabs that one out in center field, a medium fly ball. But
it's been amazing so far today to see this team, how it plays when they play clean on
indeed,
the infield.
Indeed. So now Brick Paskowitz at the plate. Paskowitz 1-for-3. He singled back in the fifth and struck out in the first. The first pitch to Brick Paskowitz on the outside. The count 1-0. Karkeny the pitch. In there for a called strike. Evens up the count 1-1. Karkeny, the big righty out of the Masters College. The pitch from Karkeny. And that is misplayed by Caleb Potter as Brick Paskowitz pops that one into left field. Potter going to get the ball, and Paskowitz with a stand-up triple. And Potter was playing so deep in. And he misread that one, and now the Miners with a runner on third and one out, and that is trouble.
First step was in, apart from out. Tough one.
So now Chris Hall is the batter for the Matsu Miners. Runner on third, one out here in a 2-2 game. Top of the seventh inning. The pitch from Jason Karkeny. In there for a called strike. Hall on the day. 2-for-2. He has scored both of the runs for the Matsu Miners. The 0-1 pitch from Karkeny. Misses low and away.
You know, that's going to be one play in the scorebook that doesn't go down as an error, but could be magnified here, especially in a close game.
That looks like an F7 off the bat, Gear. One ball, one strike, one out here. Runner at third. Swing and a miss from Chris Hall.
But Jason Karkeny going out there, so that's okay. I'll get him. I'll get this next guy.
Karkeny, a great guy to be around, confident, fun guy, brother of Stephen Karkeny, currently playing in the Milwaukee Brewers organization, the two-time Chinook there. And now here's the 1-2 pitch from Karkeny, and that's popped foul over the press box. So the count 1-2. And Jason Karkeny, if nothing else, the number one suspect of who was slashing the laser pointer in me and Garrett's eyes against the Anchorage Glacier Pilots. And he knows. 1-2. And that is ripped into right field. Under it to make the grab is Jacob Brobst. The throw home will be not in time. Brick Paskowitz tags up and scores there. So now the Matsu Miners taking a 3-2 lead. Like you said, Garrett, the misread by Caleb Potter becomes a lot bigger now.
For the Miners, number 21, Vance is getting up.
So now two out, nobody on. The Miners lead by a score of 3-2 here in the top of the seventh inning. The batter, Vance Vizcaino. The first pitch to Vizcaino in there for a called strike. The 0-1. And that is a foul ball. Sails out of play on the left field side. So the count 0-2 here on Vizcaino on the day. Reached on an error, reached on a fielder's choice, grounded into a double play. So I guess that puts him at 0-3. And this kind of fouls that one back, so we're going to redo 0-2 here. The count is 0-2. The pitch from Carcenny, and that is drilled into center field. Going back is Dave Morton and Caleb Potter. They're going to converge. Dave Morton diving for it, can't make the grab. Caleb Potter grabbing it, the throw. And Vance Vizcaino with the second triple of the inning for the Matsu Miners. And now a runner at third with two outs. And the batter will be Matt Diorio.
Coming to the plate for the Miners, number 9, Matt Diorio.
And the full extension from Dave Morton to try to make the grab out there, just not enough. So that was going to be Matt Diorio. The first pitch to Diorio, swing and a miss. Oh, 1. Okay, delivers. And that's just low. And that's going to miss for ball 1. And that's pot foul, and that's going to go out of play behind the backstop. So Carcenny ahead in the count here, 1-2. And a big pitch for Jason coming up here, trying to prevent any further run scoring by the Matsu Miners, with Vance Vizcaino standing at third base. The pitch from Jason, and that's ripped into center field. Chasing is Dave Morton, and that's going to drop in for a hit. Into score comes Vance Vizcaino. And a single for Matt Diorio extends the lead for the Matsu Miners to 4-2. And just kind of a tough pill to swallow if you're the Chinooks. With action going in their bullpen, looks like Travis Stone about to start warming up out there. And now Niles Nygaard will be the batter.
An inning that should have been well over.
The pitch misses low, ball 1. And that's a pop-up. Chasing it in foul ground is going to be Tyler Boxwell and Michael Staudinger. Staudinger is there to make the grab for the third out of the inning. But the Miners tack on 2 there after a series of unfortunate events in the field for the Chinooks. And as we head into the bottom of the 7th, the score 4-2, Matsu Miners. And Garrett, tough pill to swallow there.
Yeah, just don't even know what to say about it. I mean, not a hard hit ball by Paskowitz. Not even a high hit ball. A line shot at ideally,
like,
first step is back for an outfielder, not in. And
ideally,
not,
that's a double, not a triple.
Not read well at all by Potter, and it just went all the way to the wall. And especially when the next hitter flies out to on a routine play to right, just makes you cringe.
So the score 4-2, Matsu Miners. And the pitcher is Caleb McCann out of Appalachian State University. And it looks like Patrick Cromwell is going to start things off for the Chinooks here.
And number 33 for the Miners is Caleb McCann.
So as Caleb McCann takes his warm-up pitches, we're just going to step off for a quick second. go. And we're back here, bottom of the seventh, 4-2 Miners. And Patrick Cromwell trying to get something started here for the Chinooks as they trail by a score of 4-2 here in the bottom of the seventh inning of action. And that was kind of awkward. My phone went off. The first pitch from Cromwell, and that is off the mound, but to the second baseman Schleppenbach, the throw to first in time. And Patrick Cromwell retired on one pitch. So that's going to bring up Jake Brobst. Brobst on the day, a pair of strikeouts and a groundout, 0-3. And that makes him 0 for his last 7. The first pitch to Brobst, and there's a fly ball into right center field. Going back is the right fielder, and that drops in for a hit. Brobst rounding first to second, and he's going to be in at second with a stand-up double. So Jacob Brobst makes his presence known in the leadoff spot for the first time today, a stand-up double with one out here, and the Chinooks are back in business with Dave Morton coming to the plate. Famous Dave Morton, the Cincinnati native. Second baseman for Xavier. One for three on the day. He had a big-time single and came around to score back in the fourth. That pair of groundouts on the other side back in the fifth and first. Morton looks to get the Chinooks something here. The first pitch to Dave, taken on the outside, ball one. So the count 1-0. Jake Brobst stands at second with one out here. And Morton fouls that one back into the screen as Tyback scurries to get that ball. So that evens the count. One ball, one strike, one out here in the bottom of the seventh. 4-2 Miners. The pitch from McCann. In there for a called strike. McCann looks back to second. He delivers. Breaking ball on the outside. The count evens up 2-2. And Caleb McCann, by no means invincible, as Jake Brobst went out and proved right there. A 5.4 ERA on the season. The pitch, Dave Morton pops that one. Foul ball out of play. Staying alive in this at-bat is famous Dave Morton, the pride of Cincinnati. Two balls, two strikes, one out here. Jake Brobst at second. McCann looks to the catcher Plunkett. He sets, delivers. And Morton loops that one into deep center field. Going back as Brick Paskowitz makes an amazing diving grab. So tagging up at second base is Jacob Brobst. He goes to third. And what can be said for that catch there by Brick Paskowitz? He extended his entire body out there. Like Superman, extending for that ball and robbing Dave Morton of extra bases. But Jake Brobst tags up there anyway. So now, Matt Ferrudo at the plate. Ferrudo on the day. 1-for-3, 2 flyouts, and a single. The single that advanced Dave Morton to third base for the first run of the Chinooks day. And now the pitching coach, Matt Greeley, out there to have a quick chat with Caleb McCann. And as they meet some action in the bullpen for the Matsu Miners, and he might just be trying to buy time to see if it does not work out, the move can be made to the bullpen, as well as probably trying to come up with some strategy about how to deal with Ferrudo, a guy that's kind of been tearing up the Matsu Miners as much as one can do so in this league against this all-star pitching staff that the Miners have. So in the first pitch to Matt Ferrutto, Ferrutto lays down bunt. Coming in is Jacob Brose, but that ball just rolled foul, even though it looked very good off the bat. Looked like a textbook bunt.
Two-out suicide squeeze. Risky play. Might have paid off, but just did kick foul. And with Frew at the plate, unsuspecting, as Nygaard playing very deep at third, almost got it halfway up the line just enough.
So I would bet that they're probably not going to do that again. That may have been an element of the surprise thing. Still deep. But you're right, Nygaard still playing very deep at third base. The pitch taken on the outside corner, a called strike. So the count, nothing in two here. Caleb McCann, the 0-2 pitch on the outside, ball one. But what it comes down to, Garrett, is Paskowitz kind of robbed the Chinooks of a huge potential rally, as Dave Morton really made great contact with that ball, but gosh, as Ferrutto fouls that one down the third base line. Because if that ball drops in, especially with Paskowitz, if he extended his body like that, if he didn't make the catch, then it would be Morton probably at second or third with one out in this situation, and a fly ball from Ferrutto could tie the game, but the Chinooks still fighting to get something out of this one. And Ferrutto rocks that one into right field, but under it to make the grab is Chris Hall for the third out of the seventh inning. So after seven innings of play here, the score 4-2 in favor of the Matsu Miners. We're going to step off for just a second, but don't go anywhere. Two more innings of action remain. Listening to Chinooks Radio. And we are here for the top of the eighth inning. Andrew, Alex, Garrett, Mansfield here in the booth, and Jason Carkenny out for another inning of work. 4-2 in favor of the Matsu Miners is the score, and the first batter will be Connor Wanhanen. The first pitch to Wanhanen is taken on the outside, ball one. The pitch, swing and a miss. A big hack there from Wanhanen. Wanhanen, 0-3 on the day. Fly out, ground out, strike out. The pitch from Carkenny. Grounded to the first baseman, Michael Staudinger. He is going to take it himself for the first out of the inning. So another struggling day for Connor Wanhanen. 0-4. And now Tyler Wolf to the plate. Wolf, strikeout, fly out, single. 1-3. The pitch from Carkenny. Taken in there for a called strike. So the count 0-1. Carkenny looks to the catcher, Tyler Boxwell. Takes the sign, sets, and delivers. Low and inside. Brings the count to 1-1.
The 1-1 pitch. Inside again, ball two. And Jason Karkiainen, you know, got to be a little bit disappointed with the way last inning turned out. What could have been a routine flyout kind of turning against the tide there of what he expected in a misread from Caleb Potter. And ultimately, without errors, this could be a 2-1 ball game in favor of the Chinooks, Garrett. The pitch. And that is fouled down the first base line. Or third base line, check that. So two balls, two strikes, one out here. The pitch from Karkiainen. Looped into center field, a base hit, Morton under it. So a single for Tyler Wolfe. And now with one out here in the top of the eighth inning, the Mattsu Miners have a man aboard, and the batter will be Zach Plunkett. Plunkett on the day, 0 for 3, went down looking his first time up, then a ground out and a fly out. But looks like this is going to be it for Jason Karkiainen. Jordan Vieira coming to the mound. Looks like he's going to take the ball. The guy in the bullpen is Travis Stone. And Vieira talks to Karkiainen. As Travis Stone looks on from the bullpen. And they're going to leave him out there. So a very uncommon situation where Vieira comes out and does not make a substitution himself. Normally the pitching advice conversations are left to the likes of pitching coach Chris Beck. So it looks like Karkiainen thinks he can take Plunkett himself, and we'll see how it goes here. The pitch popped up sky high. Chasing it in foul ground is Michael Staudinger. Well, that's going to go just out of play into the Mattsu Miners fan section over there in shallow right field. So the count, 0-1. The score, 4-2, Mattsu Miners. One out, Tyler Wolfe, the runner at first. Top of the eighth inning. Karkiainen's pitch, swing and a miss. And Jason Karkiainen getting ahead in the count here, 0-2. To the likes of TCU catcher Zach Plunkett. Karkiainen sets, delivers, and that's grounded to the third baseman, Patrick Cromwell. It's going to slip by him as he dives in there, gets in there to left field. So now runners at first and second, one out. And that was the Mattsu Miners' 10th hit of the day. And Jordan Vieira making another trip to the mound here, and looks like this is going to be it. So, the new pitcher is going to be Travis Stone, and that's it for Jason Karkiainen. We're going to step off for just a second here. You are listening to Chinooks Radio. So we are back here. Top of the eighth inning, one out, runners at first and second for the Matsui Miners. The new Chinook pitcher, Travis Stone. Stone, the submarine-style pitcher. The first pitch, in there for a called strike. Travis spent his last season at Stephen F. Austin alongside Tyler Boxwell, who's catching him right now, and Grant Page. The 0-1. And that's grounded back to Travis Stone, makes the athletic play, the throw to Hunter Hanks to first. In time, a double play. A 1-6-3 double play. Travis Stone gets the Chinooks out of trouble in the top of the eighth. And Travis Stone, help yourself out there, buddy. Gets the Chinooks out of trouble. So that's going to close the book on Jason Karkeny. 1.2 innings pitched. 5 hits, 2 runs, both of them earned. And no walks, no strikeouts. He faced 10 batters during that time. 67148. And Garrett actually brought up an interesting point to me. Travis Stone is the Chinook's leader in whip. And that's walks plus hits divided by innings pitched, if I'm not mistaken. So Travis Stone with that double play there, shutting him down. And now the pitcher for the Matsui Miners. He's going to be Corbin Martin. Martin, the freshman at Texas A&M. So as Corbin Martin takes his warm-up pitches, we're going to step off for just a second. But we'll be like right back. Chinooks Radio, you're listening to it. And we head into the bottom of the eighth here at Lee Jordan Field. The new pitcher for the Matsui Miners is Corbin Martin. And leading things off here is Michael Staudinger. The first pitch to Staudinger, taken on the outside. The Chinooks trail 4-2 in this game. And Staudinger fouls that one back over the screen. So the count 1-1. On Michael Staudinger. And that's in there for a called strike. The count stands at 1-2. The 1-2 pitch from Corbin Martin. And Staudinger grounds that one into the gap, but Tyler Wolf with the athletic play. Staudinger is going to run it out. An infield hit for Michael Staudinger, and the Chinooks are in business here in the bottom of the eighth inning. So the first guy to see Corbin Martin in Michael Staudinger cracks a hit. And that's going to be number 6. For the Chinooks on the deck. And now Holt Davis will be the batter. Davis hitless on the deck. The first pitch to Holt Davis in on the knees. He had to get out of that one. The count is nothing and two, and Holt Davis, 1-0. And now the count evens up at 1-1 as Holt Davis fouls that one off. over the Matsey Minor dugout. The pitch. Two and one is the count. The pitch from Corbin Martin. Oh. And that is inside. A low and inside strike two taken by Holt Davis. So two balls, two strikes, nobody out. Michael Staudinger stands at first in the bottom of the eighth inning here. Corbin Martin sets, delivers the 2-2. In the dirt, scooped up there by Zach Plunkett, and the count goes full. Three balls, two strikes, and nobody out here. And with Foxy Boxy, the master of disguise, in the on-deck circle. A lot of potential here. The 3-2. Swing and a miss. Holt Davis goes down swinging for the first out of the bottom of the eighth.
Coming to the plate for the Chinooks, number 15, Tyler Boxwell.
So the master of disguise looking to become a different person here. The first pitch in there for a called strike. The count 0-1. Michael Staudinger stands at first. The 0-1 pitch taken on the outside. A close one. Ball one. And the tension is real here in Chugiak. The 1-1 pitch. And that's just misses upstairs from Corbin Martin. So the count, two balls, one strike, one out here. Starting here at first. The Chinooks trailing this game by a score of 4-2. The 2-1. A slider scooped up there. Ball three. So a big time hitter's count for Tyler Boxwell. The count 3-1. And Tyler Boxwell looking to get the fish back into this one. The 3-1 pitch. And Boxwell's going to ground that one to the third baseman, Niles Nygaard. He goes to second for one. The throw to first in time. A 5-4-3 double play puts the Chinooks down here in the bottom of the eighth. So we're going to head to the ninth. The Chinooks trail by a score of 4-2. But as they say in baseball, it ain't over till it's over. Stay tuned. You are listening to Chinooks Radio. And we are in the ninth inning here. The score is 4-2. Matthew Myers, Travis Stone came in and got a 1-6-3 double play to get the Chinooks out of a jam last time, and he's in here for his second inning of work. And the first pitch from the Submariner, the Stone Cone Killer. Travis Stone is in there for a called strike. The count 0-1. The batter is Rick Paskowitz. The pitch, and Brick grounds that one to Matt Ferruda, the throw to Michael Staudinger at first in time, the first out of the inning. So, one up, one down here for Travis Stone. And that's going to bring up Chris Hall. Hall on the day. Two for three. Two for two, actually. He has a pair of singles, scored two runs, a sacrifice fly, driving in one himself, and he also drew himself a walk. And Chris Hall grounds that one to the shortstop, Hunter Hanks, the throw to Michael Staudinger at first, in time. And quickly, Travis Stone gets himself two outs in the ninth inning. And that's going to bring up the enemy of the Chinooks, Vance Vizcaino. The first pitch to Vizcaino is fouled off. And, of course, we are here to remind you that me and Garrett's broadcast is brought to you by BP. Powering Alaska's future. So 0-1 the count on Vance Vizcaino. Stone sets, delivers. In there for a called strike. So the count, nothing and two here. And Vizcaino showing off that big smile. Someone made a joke. Probably Tyler Boxwell, known for his sense of humor. The pitch misses low, ball one. So the count, one ball, two strikes, two outs here in the top of the ninth inning. The base is empty, and the Matthew Miners lead this game by a score of 4-2. Stone looks to the catcher Boxwell for the sign. He delivers. Ball two. The fans are not happy about that judgment from the umpire. Stone. The count evens up at 2-2 now. Vance Vizcaino in the box. The 2-2 pitch is grounded right back at the mound, and coming around to get it is Matt Ferruto. The throw to Staudinger, nowhere near in time and nowhere near the bag. So give Vance Vizcaino another hit. That's a reoccurring theme of this season. Give Vance Vizcaino a hit. Seems like the only guy in the Chinooks rotation that could figure him out was Connor Menez. So now Diorio at the plate. Vance Vizcaino at first, two outs here, top of the ninth. And the Central Florida Knight fouls that one off the first pitch, so the count 0-1. Two down here in the top of the ninth inning. Travis Stone at the mound, looks into Boxwell, delivers the pitch outside. The count, one ball, one strike, with two outs. The 1-1. And that's cracked into left field. Chasing back is Caleb Potter. He's not going to get there. It rolls to the wall. Coming around third is the speedy Vizcaino. He's going to come in to score. Strolling into second with a stand-up double is Matt Diorio. So that extends the lead for the Matthew Miners to 5-3. Or 5-2, check that.
For the Miners, number 16, Niles Nygaard.
And that's going to bring up Niles Nygaard. The first pitch from Travis Stone. Low, ball one. Matt DiOrio stands at second base. The pitch in there for a called strike. So the count evens up at 1-1. Stone about to throw his 15th pitch of the afternoon. He deals outside, ball one, ball two. 2-1. Two down. Here in the top of the ninth inning, with the Miners already having scored one here. Travis Stone looking to sit him down before they can cause any further damage. The pitch is grounded to the first baseman, Staudinger. The toss to Stone is in time as Stone gets in there. So the Miners add one more in the top of the ninth and lead this game 5-2. The closer, Brick Paskowitz, is coming in. But the Chinooks have one more shot at this one. Don't go anywhere, folks, because this one could get real exciting. As Brick Paskowitz takes his warm-up pitches, we're going to step off. But don't go anywhere. You are listening to Chinooks Radio. The bottom of the ninth it is. Last licks for the Chugiak Eagle River Chinooks here as they trail 5-2 against the Massey Miners, and a pinch hitter here. Batting in the place of Caleb Potter will be Caden Owens. Brick Paskowitz, the closer, is in. The first pitch, outside, ball one. The story of this one, the Miners put up runs in the first and third. The Chinooks respond with a pair in the fourth. And as Caden Owens takes ball two there. But then the Matsu Miners breaking this one open with two in the seventh and one in the top of the ninth. The pitch, and that is ball three. Brick Paskowitz can't seem to find the zone here. And if you're Caden Owens, a guy that has been a huge threat to score, anytime he gets on base for the Chinooks, you're probably taking all the way on this fastball. And that's in there for a called strike.
Getting on base is his one job right here. Not asked to do it all, but just get aboard and give him a shot.
3-1, the pitch from Paskowitz, and that is outside, ball four, so the Chinooks have the leadoff guy aboard in Caden Owens. And that's going to bring up Andrew Mogg. And he'll be hitting in the place of Hunter Hanks.
Moggy giving the day off behind the dish in favor of Tyler Boxwell, who had quite a day for himself. But Mog looking to keep the Chinooks in this one. The Filipino phenom. The first pitch is, and that is a fly ball deep left field. Under it is the left fielder. Vizcaino makes the grab for the first out. As Caden Owens is going to retreat back to first base.
Now batting for your Chinooks, number 8, Patrick Cromwell.
So now Patrick Cromwell, the batter. Cromwell still to get a hit against the Matsu Miners this season. And that one sails in the zone, called strike one. Rick Paskowitz looks to first base, sets, delivers, and that misses up and away. The count, one ball, one strike, with one out here in the bottom of the ninth. Caden Owens, the runner at first, Paskowitz's pitch, misses again, ball two. So the count, 2-1. The 2-1 misses low and away, ball three. So Patrick Cromwell behind in the count, 3-1 here. Or ahead in the count, 3-1 here. Three balls, one strike, one out here. Brick Paskowitz having trouble finding the zone here. The closer for the Matsu Miners. The pitch, and that is fouled off, out of play down the left field line. It looks like Cromwell probably broke his bat there. And he's going to walk back, give the bat to Ty Beck, and grab a new one. A full count here on Patrick Cromwell, the California kid out of Santa Ana College. With one out here in the bottom of the ninth, and the Chinooks trailing by 3 runs with a runner on first. The pitch, and that misses outside, ball four. So now the tying run is at the plate in Jacob Brost. And the pitching coach, Greeley, is going to come out and have a quick chat with Brick. And talking to Kevin and Kyle, the Miners broadcasters, they were talking about Brick as a person, saying that, you know, he could have the bases loaded, nobody out in the bottom of the ninth, and he's still calm, cool, and collected, but right now, he looks anything but.
Yep, struggling with his control, and really going to have to work hard to pick up his 7th save on the year.
So now Brost is going to be the batter. Brost on the day, 1-for-3. He doubled back in the 7th his last time up. Other than that, a pair of strikeouts and a ground out. So now the Ohio State Buckeye, Jacob Brost at the plate. Runners at first and second. Cromwell at first. Caden Owens at second with one out here. Brost represents the tying run. Brick Paskowitz having trouble finding the strike zone. The first pitch, in there for a called strike. He found it there. So the count 0-1 on the Ohio State Buckeye, Jacob Brost. Runners at first and second, one out here at the bottom of the ninth inning. The Chinooks trailing by 3 runs. The pitch. And that misses low and away. One and one. And Probst fouls that one off. And Paskowitz kind of looks like not very a very physically imposing guy per se, but kind of got the Tim Lincecum body with a velocity that's just not too far off. The 1-2. Swing and a miss, and Probst goes down. So a strikeout, and now the Chinooks down to their final out. And the last hope for the Chinooks is going to be famous Dave Morton. Morton on the day, 1-for-4. He came around to score. Back in the fourth inning, the first run that the Chinooks scored today. The first pitch to Dave. Way inside, ball one. The count 1-0. Dave Hales out of Cincinnati, Ohio. The 1-0. And Dave Morton fouls that one out of play to the left field side. One ball, one strike, two outs here with Caden Owens in second. And Patrick Cromwell in first. The Chinooks down to the final out of the game. The pitch. And Matt misses outside, just off the plate. 2-1. And Paskowitz.
I think the big one right here for Morton is definitely everybody is aware of who is on deck. It's Matt Furuto. Extend this ball game the best you can.
And that one up and away. It's now a hitter's count for Dave Morton.
To get Furuto against Paskowitz is going to be a big matchup for the Chinooks. Definitely the guy you're going to want to play.
And Gary, if you remember, Brick Paskowitz, the pitcher, robbed Dave Morton of what would have been a triple.
Caruso playing well over towards left here as well.
And Dave Morton's going to pop that one up, but it's going to go out of play. So now three balls, two strikes, two outs. Dave Morton represents the tying run in this ballgame. But it's the bottom of the ninth. The Fish down to their last hope in famous Dave. 3-2, the pitch, and that's way outside. Dave Morton's going to trot to first, and now bases are loaded for Matt Furuto. And Garrett, there is no one else the Chinooks would want up in this situation right now than the guy that they have.
Absolutely. If they was going to pick anybody, it's who I would want right here.
And Brick Paskowitz passes, not allowed a hit, but a ton of control issues for the Lincecum lookalike. The pitch, and Furuto rips that one into center field. Coming around third is Caden Owens. So that's going to score one for the Chinooks, and now the Chinooks trailing this ball game 5-3. Matt Furuto keeps them alive in this one. And now, a guy with the power to put the Chinooks, to give the Chinooks the win. The winning run is on first base for the Chinooks, and Michael Staudinger is the batter. Patrick Cromwell at third, famous Dave Morton at second, representing the tying run. The go-ahead run, Matt Furuto at first. Two outs. The first pitch to Staudinger is popped up, and that's going to go foul. Play is going to be close, but it's going to go over the fence and out of play. And a close one there. And now Michael Staudinger. Channel the Fairbanks vibes.
Base hit could tie this one. If you hit one in the alley, it could end it.
And that one right back into the screen. So starting her behind in the count 0-2 to Paskowitz. And this is a dangerous position to be in. But the base is loaded. Cromwell at third, Morton at second, Furuto at first. The 0-2 pitch on the outside, ball one. One ball, Two strikes, two outs, bottom of the ninth. The base is loaded. The Chinooks trail by two. Paskowitz looks to the catcher, Zach Plunkett. He winds up, delivers. And that hit Michael Staudinger. So now coming around is Patrick Cromwell. So now this is getting extremely, extremely interesting. The tying run is at third base in Dave Morton. The winning run is at second base in Matt Ferrugo. And now it's up to Holt Davis with the opportunity. A single could win this game for the Chinooks if you get it into the gap. And right now the gaps in left center and right center look as big as the Matsu Valley. Paskowitz delivers. And he misses low and away, so that's ball one. The count 1-0. The Chinooks trail 5-4. The bases are loaded. The batter Holt Davis and Brick Paskowitz having all kinds of trouble here in the ninth inning. The 1-0. And he misses low and inside, so the count 2-0. A big-time hitter's count for Holt Davis. The count 2-0. And that's inside 3-0. And they're saying he did not go. So now Brick Paskowitz is one ball away from extending this game at the minimum. Three balls. No strikes, two outs. The pitch in there for a called strike, and the fans don't like that one at all.
He's going to make him earn it. He's going to have to get up there and have it either in the zone, make him do it on a hit, and possibly end it, or get the walk on the next pitch.
3-1, the pitch. Swing and a miss. And he swung at a ball there, Gare.
He might have.
So the count is full.
Tough telling.
At least the way it was framed, that's how it looks, but you never know where it crossed the plate. With a velocity like Paskowitz. Full count, two outs, the bases loaded, the runners go. In there for a called strike, 3, and that's the ball game. The final score, Matsu Miners 5, Chugiak Eagle River Chinooks 4. And Holt Davis having some words with the umpire as he walks off, but that one was interesting at the end there, Garrett.
Oh, it certainly was, and hats off to the Miners and Brick Paskowitz for nailing down and just finding a way to get out of it. Can't ask for a better ball game. If you're the Chinooks, you walk away from this one very much more proud than you did last night. What a ball game, but what can you do? Davis didn't get the bat off his shoulder, but wow, just heck of a day, heck of a ball game.
Yeah, so the final score, the Matsu Miners 5, the Chugiak Eagle River Chinooks 4. And like Garrett said, you know, we may not have gotten a W, but a kind of a, you can take things out of certain losses. And that one was certainly a massive improvement over yesterday's debacle of the game. And the Chinooks with the opportunity to split this series tomorrow, as we're going to be back here, same place, same time, same team, as the Chinooks will take on the Matsu Miners here at Lee Jordan Field at 7 p.m. tomorrow. And that's going to be it for us. For I am Andrew Alex, he is Garrett Mansfield. An interesting game. Thanks for you guys that stuck with us all night. From the top of the world to wherever you may be tonight, have a good evening. We'll see you tomorrow.